everybody. Thanks for being here. This presentation is about the new features the new major features we added in Oxygen 19.0. Oxygen 19.0 is a major release, meaning that we invest about 6 months of development effort into it. Usually major releases have more features than minor releases. Also, when you see an application and you see the list of features, that's the tip of the iceberg, you know. So there are lots of small features and small bug improvements and fixes that do not meet the front page. We have an Oxygen XML YouTube channel. So if at some point you want to register on it, we keep adding webinars there. For example, we added a short video about what's new in Oxygen 19, and you have lots of other videos that you can look at. For example, if you want to get started using a certain technology, you can look at that channel and maybe use it as a starting point. It's a mixture of webinars and video demonstrations that over time we made with Oxygen. And we'll start with the data editing improvements. Data, for those of you who do not know.
Do we want to poll and see who's yeah. different?
So which one of you is interested in data, for example? Anybody dog book? Okay.
Yeah.
TI? Okay, if you are. Jets, maybe.
Anything you should say, mention,
have to mention.
EPUB.
EPUB, okay. Yeah, EPUB is more like an output format. Data is an XML vocabulary for technical documentation. It has two main concepts. For those who do not know data, it has the concept of data map and the concept of data topic. So basically with data, you write small topics explaining various things in your user's manual, and then you use the data map like a table of contents and assemble them. And we'll get to the demonstration. Let's say I have a data map, and I'm opening it in a data maps manager. So this is the table of contents which shows all the topics in my data project, and I can arrange them in order to make the table of contents of the published output look in a certain way. And we added a certain view. So if we go to the window menu show view, we have the data reusable components view. And this view should show you all the keys defined in your root map, in your current data map. Keys are used in data for indirect references and for defining small pieces of content. For example, if I go here and I say append child key definition with keyword, I can add a key called product, the keyword being Oxygen XML editor. So the main idea is, whenever I will be using this product key, in the published output I will get Oxygen XML editor published. So this key will be automatically converted to the product name. So if I go to a data topic and I place the caret inside it, I can see that my product key has appeared in the data reusable components. Because in most projects you have lots of keys, you have a quick find filter here. So I can search for product and reduce the list of keys which are proposed to me. I have a small description column which shows me the text that will be used instead of the key when the publishing is done. And I have a definition location column showing me the data map where the key is defined. And this definition location is useful because I can group keys by definition location and see keys grouped by the data maps in which they are defined. So that I can have multiple data maps in my project, so I have can have a root map and submaps, and I can divide my keys in submaps depending on what they do. For example, I can have keys referencing to images, and I can have an images data map, and I can have keys references to small pieces of text like reusable text data map. So it's another way of filtering out and showing keys for a certain purpose. If I go to this key, so I place the caret somewhere in the data topic, double click, and I'm inserting a key ref to that key. In Oxygen, the key ref looks expanded. If I look in the text editing mode, I have phrase key ref product. I can also insert the key ref directly in the text editing mode. So for advanced data users, for people who don't want to use the author visual editing mode, you can use the view to insert keys also in the text editing mode. Hello, welcome. Please try to find some seats. Maybe there's one here.
Three, mm-hmm. Four. There's five up here.
Yeah.
So this key will save into your XML file forever, right? After you edit, it will save
yeah.
in there.
So once I am adding a key ref, I can save, and my topic will have a reference to that particular key. And this reference will be expanded in a publish output to the text which I assigned to the key.
Why so you chose the source of the data?
In the data map I defined the key, and it looks like this. So I have key def keys product, and I defined a keyword for it. I did not define it manually. I used right click again, append child, key definition keyword. So this is a useful idea to define a key and to link it to a small piece of text. Coming back, you can also drag and drop to insert keys. So instead of double clicking, you can go like this. Again, insert a key reference. Or you can right click here and say, insert as variable. So there are various ways to do that, the same thing. Or if you want to insert the key ref as a particular data element, you can go insert as key ref, and instead of choosing key phrase, you can choose another data element name. I will define now a key pointing to a topic. So I have this garden preparation topic. I can say edit properties, and I'm defining a key like preparation. Click OK, and let's try to use this key. So I'm in the reusable components, and I found the preparation key here. It doesn't have a description assigned to it because it doesn't define a keyword on it, but it has an href, so you can use the href part to see where the key is pointing to. And just to show you in the data map how this looks like, so the garden preparation topic reference has an href to garden preparation, and the key is called preparation, which I've assigned to it, not manually again, but by using the edit properties action in the data map. Going to one random topic, I can say I want to insert a link to the garden preparation, so I can double click it, and Oxygen inserts a link to this particular topic, and I can follow the link. So this will be a link in the published output. I can again also drag and drop. Again, a link is inserted, so when you double click and drag and drop, the most convenient action for you would be done. But you can also take control and right click and say either insert as link, which is the default action, or insert as variable, or insert as key ref and design your own, the name of the data element which will be used for inserting this this key ref. Yeah, so this is the data reusable components view, which we plan to extend further, and we'll talk more about this on what we plan next for Oxygen. So right now it only shows the list of keys, and you can insert key reference to each of them and have an account of all the keys defined in your data map. Moving on, let's say that there are times when as a technical writer you have a pretty good idea about how a certain chapter in your data map would look like. For example, in my data map I will insert an installation chapter which will have two topic references, like Windows installation and Linux installation. So as a technical writer I can try to follow a top-down approach. First define the skeleton in my data map containing topics, and then fill each topic out. So with Oxygen 19 I can say fast create topics. Maybe I can go here, fast create topics, and we have a new dialog here. And this will allow me to create new skeleton topics, so topics which only contain titles. So here I can define the table of contents that I want to insert in the data map. So I will go with installation, and then I'm using tab to define the hierarchy in this this list of topics. Windows installation and Linux installation, and then I have various checkboxes, like if I should use the file name to generate the ID attribute on the topic, and the type of topic which should be used to create all these stub files. For example, if I want to create topics or maybe concepts and so on. In my case I will create topics, and if I should use this new hierarchy as children of the current topic reference, or as siblings after the current topic reference. So I can go as siblings and I can create this, and as you see Oxygen automatically created three new topics for me. So after this, as a technical writer, I can click each one and make it, you know, add some content to it. So this dialogue again is useful if you have a pretty good idea about the structure of the topics that you want to add next in your data map. Moving on, a feature which should be quite interesting to data users would be the possibility to convert various data topic types to other topic types. So, for example, this is a data task. If you look in the text mode, it has a certain doc type, and it has a root name and the task body and so on. And this is, for example, a data topic. So it has a topic root element name, the topic doc type, and tasks and topics in data are quite similar. But let's say as a technical writer I start by creating a data task, and at some point I want to convert it to a data topic. And until Oxygen 19.0 I was supposed to manually make modifications to the task, for example to convert it to a topic, and then to have this as a body, and then to rename the doc type and so on. So with Oxygen 19.0 I can right click the task and say refactoring, and I have various convert actions: convert to concept, convert to reference, to task, to topic, or to troubleshooting, which is a new data 1.3 specialization. And if I choose to convert it to a topic, I can later choose, okay, what do you want to convert to a topic? Do you want to convert the selected references in the data map, all open files, the current data map hierarchy? So basically, this action is so powerful that it doesn't work only on the current edited file, you can use it to convert a, to batch convert a set of data topic types to other formats. Right now I'll convert only this topic, so I say selected data map references because I have only one selection. I have various filters here which I do not really need to set right now, and I can have a preview and see what Oxygen will do. So Oxygen will change its doc type, will change the root element name, and will change various elements to fit in the target data topic type. And I can go finish, and Oxygen has reloaded the open topic and properly generated the tags for it. So this action should be quite useful if at some point you decide to convert a data topic type to another data topic type, or to convert more than one data topic type to other topic types. Just to refresh my memory, we have master file support for data. This should be quite useful if you're using data from a local repository. If you're using a CMS, sometimes the CMS implements a similar functionality. So let's say I have a data project on my local disk and I'm not sure what the master data map is. So I can ask Oxygen, like, detect the master files for me and specify I want to detect the main data map, the data map which references all other maps and topics in my project. So I click next and Oxygen detected my main data map, click it, and Oxygen automatically adds it to the master files folder. This is a special folder. It's a virtual folder in which you can also add manually data maps which are the top level data maps in a hierarchy. After I do this, I can perform various rename and move operations in my project. For example, I can rename entire folders. Rename this folder, like maybe to my images. And Oxygen will ask me to update the references to this folder. So I can click preview and I see that all the references to all the images will now be changed by Oxygen because they need to match the new folder name. So instead of manually updating all these references in various topics, Oxygen will update them for me. And this works because, again, because in the master files folder I defined my master data map. I can also drag and drop topics from one place to the other. For example, drag a task or multiple tasks to the concepts folder. And again, Oxygen will find all the references to my task. And for example, in this case, I have a reference to my task in the main data map. And it will replace the old folder name with the new folder name. So for batch changing, for batch refactoring your project, for moving a large quantity of topics from one place to another, for renaming images, folders, and so on, this master file support should be very important and should save you lots of time in manually making modifications. It should do all those modifications for you.
Question here.
Yes.
So master map, you only have one master map or
no,
multiple?
You can have multiple. For example, in our project we have one master map, but some projects have multiple top level maps. So in the master map you should add only the top level maps. You can add also the others, but it doesn't matter. So if I have, for example, a data map for one product and a data map for the other product, I add them both in the master files, and Oxygen should rename the topics, taking into account the fact that I have two master files.
But,
and,
but in our case, we have 100 of those top level maps.
Yeah,
but
just...
I have to add all of it?
Yes. Actually, if you use the George, what was the right click? Yeah, sometimes I have some problems on this Mac, just to restart it a little bit. So if you use our way of detecting data master files on your project, it should find all the top level maps, and you can decide. Yeah, so it should. So you go like this, and again use the detect master files, choose data, and it should find them, and populate the master files folder with all your top level data maps, because Oxygen needs to know where to start. Data resources refer to each other, and we know to need the top level maps. Moving on to data publishing improvements, we added a special engine to Oxygen which allows you to publish data topics to PDF and to style that output using CSS instead of XSLT. And
the engine is generic for any XML with the CSS to PDF, but we didn't finalize the all the interface to that before 19, so it was good to work with data already, but it would work with any XML and CSS.
Let's say I want to, for example, I'm going in my data topic and I want in the publishing to have all the titles with blue color. So I'm saying inspect styles, and the visual editing is in Oxygen is CSS based. So I can go here and find the place where the styles for the topic were defined, and I can add a new style called color.colonred. And now I have this style applied for my editing, and usually if you wanted the same thing for the PDF output, you need to customize XSLT style sheets and in order to produce XSL for output. But we added a new transformation called data map to PDF. What you see is what you get, and you can duplicate it and choose to use the formatter. As a processor, so I have the CSS processor type, so I can publish to data to PDF using CSS, either using two commercial alternatives like PrinceXML and Antenna House, or our free chemistry processor, which is now bundled with Oxygen. And this is the only change I'm making. I'm applying the transformation, and I should obtain a PDF which uses the same CSS that I'm using for editing Oxygen. And I will show you around the PDF. And so this is the PDF obtained from data and CSS. It has a main page with the title. It has a table of contents, like all the usual PDF outputs, with clickable links and page numbers. The CSS I just modified for editing was taken into account when publishing. I have links. Again, the links have the page number in the parentheses. I can follow them. I have an index page at the end with clickable index numbers. So we believe that the future for PDF output, at least for data, would be CSS based, because it's much more easier to customize the output using CSS pagination selectors than using custom XSLT code. So that was the chemistry in action, the chemistry being the name of our processor, which is free to use from Oxygen. You can try it in Oxygen 19. It's in a beta stage, but we try to be responsive and we try to invest time in this because we consider this is worth it. And chemistry will also be available as a standalone processor, which can be bought on our website separately if somebody wants to, for example, to publish on a web server. We also invest lots of time in our web help responsive output from data. And I will show you some of the improvements that we made. Let me try to reverse some changes. I go to my data map and I say I want to publish to web help responsive. And as you've seen, web help responsive has various skins which you can choose from. I will just go with the default skin. So in this particular version 19, we invested in the search feature of web help responsive. So once we generate web help responsive, you have a search field. And
I think the responsive web help can be generated also from notebook.
No. And in this search field, based on an index that Oxygen created, you can search for various items. Like, for example, a flower. One thing we did was to add a list of pages at the bottom. So, for example, if you have multiple results, so if you have lots of results, they will not come on the same page. We also added support for searching a particular set of words, like so for example, if I'm searching for flower garden, I want an exact match, so I'm using quotes, and I can see find all topics which have the words flower and garden one next to each other. If I'm searching for a couple of words and I have a word which is missing from the search, it will be reporting that it's missing in the topics which contain some of the other words. And again, when I'm typing here, Oxygen should give me a list of choices based on the short descriptions and on the topic titles that that are defined in my data map. So this list of choices again is new and is offered starting from Oxygen 19. Dogbook improvements. We updated the dogbook schemas, the latest dogbook 5.1 schemas, and to the latest dogbook XSLT style sheets. We now allow our dogbook users to publish to PDF using change tracking, Oxygen change tracking. And we have multimedia support in Dogbook. I will try to show you some of this stuff. So going back to Oxygen, in the Oxygen project, we have a Dogbook folder. It has a V5 for version 5, and we have an assembly sample. So what Dogbook added in version 5.1 was a new type of Dogbook document called assembly. You can create one from Oxygen's file new dialog. So you have the possibility to create a new Dogbook assembly. Or if you want, you can see a sample assembly in action here. A Dogbook assembly is very similar to a data map. It references various resources and defines IDs for them. And then it defines a structure, like the table of contents in the data map. So this is how Dogbook assembly looks like. And we have a new transformation scenario based on the Dogbook style sheets, which will generate a Dogbook article by taking the assembly and expanding all those topic references. So Dogbook, starting with version 5.1, also has this concept of assembly and this concept of topic. So this is a Dogbook topic. They somehow copied this idea from data because it made sense, probably. Just to show you the change tracking capabilities, I have a Dogbook sample. I have various comments added to Oxygen support for adding comments. For example, in Oxygen, I can select stuff and go and say add comment, and Oxygen will save various processing instructions in order to remember that users did various changes. Somebody, for example, here deleted a text with the change tracking on, and we have various comments here. And I can say that I want to print this with PDF show change tracking and comments. So this is the new scenario that you can use. And the generated PDF should now contain, you know, it contains highlights, and these highlights take me to the footer where I can see my comments. So for each of these, for example, this is an insertion, this is a deletion. Each of these takes me to the footer where I can see the comments made that by that particular end user, or the fact that it's a deletion or insertion. So they do not appear as callouts, but they appear as small links which can be followed to the footer section in the topic. Also, one direction in which we started improvements in Oxygen 18 .1 was Markdown. So you can create Markdown topics with Oxygen, and we added support to switch to the full tags in the preview window. So with Oxygen, I can create a Markdown file, and I have a title. I can add various list items, for example, item 1, item 2. I have a preview here in which I can see either what the generated HTML output will look like for the Markdown, or I can see what the generated data content will look like for the Markdown. And I can right click and say export as data topic, and I will have the equivalent data topic. And I can also say that I want to show the full tags in the preview window to get a better idea about what's generated. So we added support in 19 to show the full tags in this preview window. Moving on, SSLT improvements. We updated the Saxon SSLT engine in Oxygen to 9.7. It's a major version which adds extra support for XSLT 3.0. We still need to work on the Oxygen side to enable some of the XSLT 3.0 features, but some should work. We worked on our support for conversion between various XSLT structures. So we have various XSLT related refactoring operations. And we also worked on a code quality assurance on a specific schematron which adds various rules for validating SSLT. Let me switch to this. Open an SSLT. So I have this XSLT. I have an SSL choose here. And I can tell Oxygen, okay, I actually want to make it an XSL if. And I can go to refactoring, where I can have lots of XSLT based choices, like maybe I want to extract this section as a template, maybe I want to extract it as a function to create a local variable. And what's new is that I can convert the choose to an if. So I have two ifs. The first one is the first branch of the choose, and the second is the negation of the first one, because I needed to convert to an equivalent structure. Also in this SSLT document, if I validate it, I see that Oxygen reports a problem here. And let's try to validate it. So it says something like bad practice naming parameters the same as elements and attributes from XPath expressions. So in this case, for example, I created a parameter called family. And right here I have an XPath expression matching it. So Oxygen tells me that maybe you forgot to add the dollar to it to refer to the parameter. So it's just like a best practice which Oxygen uses to give you a hint, like maybe you should name your parameters different than your element names, because sometimes in the XPath you might get it wrong. You might want to refer to the parameter but forget to add a dollar in front of it. One more thing we added to Oxygen was referring to the schematron validation. Let's say I have a template and I I add documentation for it. So in Oxygen I can add documentation to each template. And once Oxygen detects that I'm using this particular way of adding documentation, it will suggest me that I should also add documentation to the other templates. No. So I can go to this template and I have a quick fix here, and Oxygen will allow me to add documentation also for it. So that again, that I achieve some consistency, that I document all my XSLT code if I choose to do that. So yeah, so these are the schematron validation fixes we added. Yeah, so the code quality assurance that I showed you, reports undocumented templates and parameters which have the same name of element names. And we also added various improvements like automatic spell checking when you add the comments to Oxygen. We have a small dialog there. Better support for editing Java properties files, some support for inserting media objects in XHTML, and support to refactor XML documents, and also change their doc type declaration. But we'll talk more about the refactoring, the XML refactoring in Oxygen in another presentation later today. And also, if you're using the Data Source Explorer in Oxygen, for example, to edit WebDAV resources, we added support to edit, for example, images and other file types directly from Oxygen's Data Source Explorer. We updated various components like support for the exist database. Our EPUB checker was updated to version 4.0.2. The export processor and the TEI schemas and style sheets. And we also have a web author. So our web author can be used to edit various kind of resources online. And the improvements we added for it was, so you can go to this more button and preferences and choose the language for your application. So switch the language, apply, and you will have Oxygen in one of these supported languages. We added in it support for detecting attribute changes. So I'm inserting an attribute to change tracking. And I can see in the review part that somebody inserted an attribute with change tracking. And I have a new view called validation, which should show me validation errors on this web application. And one thing would be, we've had the support for quick fixes in Oxygen for a long time. So I can go, based on schematron, I can go to various places and fix problems. And we added this support also in the web application. So in the web application, I will receive the same validation errors. And I can see the errors here in the new validation view. And I can also see the quick fixes here so that I can click them and improve the content in my web app, in the topic that I opened in the web app. We added support, easier support for connecting the web app to various CMSs, our web application. Yeah, and support to fold various data elements in the web application. Yeah, this concludes my presentation of the larger set of features that we added to Oxygen 19.1.0. If you have any questions, yes.
So the PDF part of it is not available on the web version. So the question is using the CSS.
So the question is if using the CSS to produce the PDF can be done from the web online version of Oxygen. And right now it cannot be done. Maybe at some point we'll have a button there like produce PDF or produce something else. But the web version of Oxygen right now is mostly intended for collaboration and writing content and not for publishing. We don't have any publishing facilities in the web version. Any other questions? Yes?
For the markdown, can you use that with specialization?
So, for example, to create a markdown topic and then to convert it to a data task?
So, we specialize away from the base data standard.
Mm-hmm.
Can you use that in markdown?
Yes, so those conversions that I showed, like convert topic to task, are based on SSLT. So just a matter of taking the SSLT and modifying it to match your doc type. So in order for the doc to have a better correspondence between the old doc type and the new doc type. So it's just SSLT work.
Using markdown, what Radu showed, that is if you use markdown in the data topic, we have mainly two options. One is to use the default and cookie plugin, which will do that conversion, and that will convert to a topic. So you can't control that in your specialization unless you modify that plugin. And you know, you can, for that plugin, it's almost so GitHub, and then you can plug in your own conversion. But then you will need to distribute your own plugin, right, to use it. We also showed at some point that dynamic conversion based on a different URL scheme. So you can use something like md dtar cut slash that point to the markdown file, and dtar or in a docbook x include or whatever, and you can define a pipeline that processing steps that will convert that target to the actual format that you want. So there are different options, but if you want to share that easily, then you can use the default DWP plugin, because you can, in a map, you can mix your specialization and default topics. It's not a problem.
One more question? Anybody? Thanks, and George?
Thank you, Radu. Yeah, I had to emphasize that conversion from one topic to another is not something hard coded. It's as Radu mentioned, he will show later on. It's based on the XSLT refactoring support that we have in Oxygen. So you can plug in different such conversions, or you can use the XSLT refactoring to do similar things for other languages. Or, and the other thing was the master file support, which probably you see that we have this idea also for XSLT, for XML schema, for relaxing schemas. So it's more generic and it helps if you use XSLT, for instance, and you split the stash into different modules. It's quite useful to discover that functionality. So maybe if you do not use that, you may look into the master file support. Yes.
Very quickly, where was the command to find map dependencies?
Map dependencies. So if I have if I have a project, unknown project, I can go and say detect master files.
Detect. Okay.
And then I say, okay, my resources are data. It's a special kind of resource. Of course, as Joe said, I can also detect SSLT master files, XML schema, and so on. And I can go with this and detect my master data map.
Right click
in the project, yeah.
Good, thank you.
No problem.
Okay.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.